Alrighty guys, this is me, the almighty D Daragon from YouTube. It's been a while since I did a video like this, or a video in general about, you know, stuff and things in life and of that sort. And, you know, it's mostly a recent pickups video, but I've been busy lately. My job schedule is everlastingly changing, and I think within the next 2 weeks I'll be Monday to Wednesday, three 12-hour shifts in a row, back to back to back. Well, not in a row, but like 3 days in a row, and then I'll have 4 free days. So probably 2 of those days I won't record nothing, but then with all that free time I definitely can record stuff again. So that's awesome. 12-hour shifts are tiring, but if I get 4 days off, I'm willing to do it. They weren't gonna keep me if I hadn't taken it, so they had to lay off people. I was a temporary position, but thankfully they kept me a little longer. Hopefully they do keep me and they find me a good asset, which I don't see how they can't, because I never really called out for a stupid specific reason. But that's besides the point. I did a lot of pickups recently, and you've probably seen some gameplays of some, but I picked up a shit ton of stuff, and I sometimes feel bad about buying this much stuff for myself. But so let's just delve right into it. It's not just games, it's more than games. There's stuff that I did buy, you know, that's not games, including all this, which is more, majority of it is games or game related, but I did buy stuff that wasn't game related. So let's get started. All right, these, I'm not sure honestly if I already showed them. I had this for PS3. I just bought it because it was really cheap. PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale for the Vita. Wanted a physical copy instead of having a download that takes up my whole thing. $5, I can't complain. Add it to my collection. Nothing too crazy about it. I actually like this game too, so it's not a bad buy in my opinion. Another one, I haven't even tried this yet to be honest. Freedom Wars for the PS Vita. I don't know if I showed this as well, but I did pick this up. It is apparently like Monster Hunter or something, and I did want to try it out. So I did pick it up. It was like 15, something like that. Brand new as well. No codes inside of it. I don't even have the card inside of it. It's a very empty box. But yeah, those are two Vita things I picked up. I also did pick up Sly Cooper for Vita, but then I gave it to my sister's boyfriend because he never played it, and I already had it on PS4, and it was only $5. So, as well as that, I also picked up a shit ton of PS3 games. Well, not a shit ton of, but I already have 2 of these, but on another system. So, Portal 2, I wanted a physical copy of it. It cost me, I think, $12, brand new, has everything in it, manual disc, works. It looks mint, $12, can't go wrong. Portal 2 is a great game. If you never played Portal 2, definitely recommend it. Another one, $8, Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. I got this on Steam. I liked it enough to pick it up, and I'm a Metal Gear fan, so I did want a physical copy of it. The download content is free now, so you definitely could try that out. Play as Sam, and I think the Wolf, and plus there's VR missions, but I think that one actually costs money. I don't know why. But did want to have a physical copy of this. It's like nice cover art. Wanted it on my shelf. I'm a Metal Gear fan, so it's not really Metal Gear related. If you actually played it, it's nothing like Metal Gear, but I bought it anyway. The next up one, or 2 games in which I never played. I'll go with the first one because I actually have history with this one. I don't have history with this one, but I did play Warhawk. I got Starhawk. Why? Because, well, I liked Warhawk when I played it back in the day, and I want to add it to collection since I still have my copy of Warhawk. I think it has a single player, but I don't think any of the trophies are single player. Maybe one of them is. Majority of it is online, and I will never get to play this online because I really don't want to delve into a game that's been out for a lot of years. So yeah, that's why I picked up this. So, yeah, just had it to collection, $8 as well. Can't complain. I did want to try it out, so, you know, at least see if the single player is any good. He plays Emmett. I think he's only a single player character. Next up one is Ninja Gaiden Yaiba, PS3, $8 as well. I watched Zero Shinobi play this. I'm a Ninja Gaiden fan. I didn't buy it when it came out. $8 could not pass up. I already have Sigma 1, Sigma 2, Ninja Gaiden 3 on PS3, and as well as I got Razor's Edge on Wii U. So, wanted Yaiba. Has a different art style, but I did want to try it out. So, Ninja Gaiden Yaiba, $8, couldn't go wrong. Zero X Shinobi didn't really like it that much, but he said it was tough. Or that's what it seemed like in his Let's Play. So, another game. You've seen me do a video on it. Hyrule Warriors. I never showed that I actually picked it up, though. But I do have the game. Was complete. $42. So, what I did was, since I paid $42, and Wii U games new are $60, I was like, huh, might as well buy the season pass. So I paid $60, I got the full complete game, and I also bought the Skyward Sword character, the costumes I'm in, and all that other jazz. So $25 season pass, $42, $67 is around how much it would cost with tax anyway. It's a pretty cool game. I'm not really the biggest Dynasty Warriors fan, but I did want to pick this up because I feel like it's going to be niche later on. I don't think it's ever going to be cheap, or at least not the physical copy. Plus, I like, you know, when developers actually try something new. And since Nintendo actually lent their game to another developer, why not support it? Why? You know? I mean, I bought a U, so I really didn't support it. So, technically. Next up are some old-ish games. And the first one is Star Fox Adventures for the GameCube. Why did I buy this? Well, I liked this as a kid. It kind of reminded me of Zelda. Well, it was pretty much Zelda just for GameCube. But it was a fun game. The dinosaur was annoying as shit. I just wanted to pick it up as the collection since I was buying retro stuff. And I think this cost me around roughly $12. So, wasn't bad of a purchase. General Scales is a pretty cool character, at least as a villain. And that's all I really had to say about that. I did enjoy the game as a kid. So, another game I picked up, never got the chance to play this one or the next one, was Wario World. Now, one thing about this, though, is that I bought this with the intention that this was legitimate. Now, there's two things that are throwing me off with this copy. I don't know if you see that little white crease roughly around here. But if you're a graphic designer like me, and you know how to print covers out, and you know when you mess up, when you cut out shapes, you get the little white edge. So, that's one, right? It's one red flag. Next one is the manual. The manual, let me show you. The manual is more saturated than the cover. So, to my belief, this is a printed out cover. Now, I'm not going to complain. I got $8. It came with the manual and the disc. So I'm not complaining. But it's a bootleg cover. They could have done a better job at hiding the fact it's bootleg. The paper, I mean, maybe I'm crazy. Maybe this is just a really old paper and it's worn out. But it did complete. I just never got the chance to play it, and it did intrigue me, and I was buying GameCube games that I never had. So, Wario World was pretty fun. I did play it on emulator. Check it out. I played it in like 1080p, and I uploaded it on YouTube, and I gave the widescreen hack, so I could do that with my games. I also put Star Fox on it. Now, this game, I never played myself, and I was shocked to find it. Now, I'm going to tell you about this. Chibi Robo. Never played it. This game always cost too much for me. I was like, I'm never going to spend that much on this game. So, I was looking through eBay. And I was like, huh, let me search GameCube games. They had a lot of GameCube games. Basically, a lot is when they put multiple games in one to buy for a certain price. So, they had Harry Potter, baseball, and then they had this. So, I went to the Liberty to contact the seller. I was like, I'll give you $20 for this. Little did they know, the disc sometimes goes for $20. I got this complete. The manual, even has the factory, the health and safety precautions, and it looks brand new. $20, this could go for like $35 to $40, and the condition that this is a really good condition copy is the disc. Now, I don't know, it maybe has like one scratch or two, but the condition I got it for, and being that I got it complete for $20, $22. Amazing. So I never played it, but I'll give you why I bought this, alright? So, let me go on. Alrighty. So, next up, what I got was some DS games, the majority DS games, and then after that, I got a few more things. Contact for the DS. People are probably like, what the fuck is Contact? Unfortunately, was not complete. Just the cartridge and the actual cover. Not bad. Paid $10. Now, the thing about this game is, it's published by Atlas, and Marvelous Interactive had made it. Now, if I'm not mistaken, these are the same people who worked on No More Heroes. And I did play this game. Back when I used to have a DS, I used to have this thing called the R4. Yes, I did pirate, and I played the fuck out of this game. Never beat it, but it was a good game. Now, the reason why I got it, well, it reminded me a lot of Earthbound. And Earthbound is a really good game. If you ever played this, if you never played this, definitely check it out. If you could get it for cheap, 20. I didn't want to pay more than 20, honestly, because I just want to add it to the collection. I found this one cheap without the manual. I was like, all right, fuck it, I'll buy it. I don't really look at the manuals that much, but I do generally like to get my games complete. But check out Contact. If you know, it was really good back when I played. Maybe times have changed and it's terrible. I don't know, but I did want to add it to the collection. Next up, Chibi Robo Park Patrol. You're like, Chibi Robo again? Funny thing about this game, it was a Walmart exclusive. When I bought it, it had a sticker over it on eBay. I guess you get in trouble if you sell this, with the intentions of it saying Walmart on it. But I did get it for roughly $8. It was practically brand new, except this case is really shitty, and it kind of chipped and broke. So that's the only unfortunate part. And it has this little residue sticker on it, so that I couldn't remove. But pretty much brand new. Comes with the manual complete. $8. Now, again, back when I pirated games, I played this. And it was rather addicting to me. I'm sure if I go back to it now, it's not going to be that great. But I just bought it more or less because of the memories. And I thought it was fun. So, I definitely suggest this game for anybody who wants something pretty fun. Now, the thing about this game, though, is that there is not much verticality, I guess vertical, like, design in it. It's more horizontal, so it's really flat playing the majority of this game. So that's the only disappointing part, but I did enjoy this for what it was back when I did play it and stole games. So I did want to add it to the collection. Definitely recommend it if you like DS games, 3D DS games at that, because there's not many. Well, there are, and most of them are majority good in my opinion, but that's just my opinion. Next up, never owned it. It always cost too much. And I did pay kind of almost like a new DS price game for it. And that's Super Princess Peach. Back when I pirated games, like I said, that's just going to be majority of what I'm saying. Played this, and it was good. Never found it cheap. Never went down in price, and I found this complete for $27. Do I regret buying this? Maybe. But when I add it to the collection, this game is more rare of the Nintendo titles. At least it's not going to go down in price anytime soon. And it was pretty fun back when I played it. It was kind of different. You actually upgraded and like paid for upgrades in a Mario game, and that was just quite strange to me at the time. And I think this was one of the first Mario games to do that. Barring Super Paper Mario did it, but in Paper Mario, but those are RPGs, and Super Paper Mario derives from an RPG. So, next up, did not pirate this game back when I had it. I actually did buy this game back when it came out, and again, quite good game when it adds a collection. I got all the Star Fox games almost except Assault, and just want to add a collection. People didn't like this one. It was more like rinse, repeat, repetitiveness. You basically draw on a tactical map, interfere with enemies, get the medals, and then you face a certain area. You chase after missiles, and you destroy the motherships. There's not much to it. They did have a different final boss that was quite different, and they had multiple endings. This one, actually, now that I remember. So this one, if you're a Star Fox fan, definitely recommend. This one I never bought or never owned. I borrowed from a friend. Never pirated either because that was back when my R4 actually broke. This came out later down the line. I'm like, I'm not buying any DS games. When I think that the new, what, this came out in 2009. Now, if I'm not mistaken, the 3DS was coming out around that time. If I'm not mistaken, where I just didn't buy many DS games at that time anymore. And I did play it. I did borrow it from a friend. It was quite fun. I'm a Mario and Luigi fan, so I had to pick it up. I think it was like 16. Again, Star Fox was like 10 as well. Just, I think I forgot to mention that. Next up, I actually did own this one. I traded it. Mario and Luigi Partners in Time. This one, honestly, I don't know. I want to say it was kind of the most boring one, but I did play it and I did own it at the time. So I did want to rebuy it. Now I own all of them, barring Superstar Saga, though I could just download it on my Wii U. And, I don't know, like, something about this game, it was just really annoying, some parts of it. Now, same Dream Team I haven't even finished yet, so that, probably that one is my least favorite one. I actually got pretty far in Bowser's Inside Story when I did borrow it, and I think I almost got to the final. I don't think I ever beat a Mario Luigi game. They're just really long. I do like the series, don't get me wrong, but after a while, kind of drag on. But, that's that. This one, I never owned. I didn't see a point to, and it was Kirby Superstar Saga. But, I own Canvas Curse, and I own Mass Attack. So, I went at liberty to buying this. Just own all Kirby games. And, if I'm not mistaken, it's just a remake of Superstar. They're kind of revamped. I don't know what else is different about it, but it was, again, roughly $12. Partners in Time as well. Was like 25. Nah, I didn't mention that. That was another one I paid a hefty price for, which I usually wouldn't, but I just wanted to add it to the collection. Another one I actually did own, this one, Kirby Squeak Squad. I traded it back when I had it. Kind of regretted it. This game was actually really fun. I liked it. You could change the color of Kirby and stuff. I remember there was like certain unlocks. I thought it was quite good. A lot of people didn't like this one. I thought this was a remake of a certain one, but apparently it wasn't. It's just a lot of people just for some reason did not like Squeak Squad. I can't figure it out. I actually really enjoyed Squeak Squad. Maybe I'm crazy. Now that I think about it, going back and playing them, Canvas Curse is probably the worst one. But at the time, I really liked Canvas Curse. And then they got that new one, Rainbow Curse, coming out, which I may get. Last but not least for the DS games, Diddy Kong Racing. Traded this as well. Or at least I think I did. I don't know where it went. I think I gave my friend a few games, and I just never got my games back. So, I mean, I let him borrow games. I had Resident Evil Deadly Silence as well, which I might try to rebuy someday, but they had the Master of Touch mode or some shit like that. It was funny. But this game, it was quite good. I tried playing it recently again, and I was like, holy shit, I can't go back to this type of game. This racing game is kind of weird. There's no drifting. I thought it was like Mario Kart, you kind of drift like that. But no, it's just really sharp turns. So. But it was fun back when I played it. And I did enjoy it. Diddy Kong Racing, that's why I added it back to my collection. But again, I forgot to mention all the games. I probably paid, I believe I paid $16 for Superstar Ultra or something. Kirby Superstar Ultra, yeah. And I paid $12 for Squeak Squad. And I think I paid another $12 for this. So, can't go wrong with these prices. That's about it for my game pickups. But still not done yet. Yes, I know this is a long video. I never bought that many Blu-rays. I only really got superhero movies. And first off, I'm going to just say I bought a few that I actually watched back in the day. This one was back in the day. These other ones, I watched one of them recently and another one my friend told me of. And these are three Blu-rays. First one is Fooly Cooly Complete. There's only like 7 episodes. But I did like this back when I watched it. I thought it was strange when I watched it as a kid on Adult Swim. So I did want to actually buy it, support it. I did like the cover. It's quite nice. As the little slide in. It's kind of the same art. But, you know, has a nice inside to the book. And the disc is cool. So I don't regret this one. I did pay kind of hefty price of, if I'm not mistaken, it's around roughly 20 something for just 7 episodes, so I'm crazy, you know. Next one is, they didn't have no cool covered looking ones, and I actually did like this series, and it is Cash Earned Sins. If you haven't watched it, it's based on Cash Ann, the original anime, except it's kind of a different plot line. And the plot line is really good in this. I'm not going to spoil it, but it's kind of a depressing anime if you actually watch it. But I thought this was unique to the Cash and Sins thing, but apparently there's a whole line of series saved. Super amazing value additions, and I just don't like the cheesy backgrounds. But it is a nice cover if it didn't have the save and the cheap ass, you know, thing. But comes with 4 discs, nothing too crazy. Right there, it's like 4 episodes on a few of the discs. See, right there, right here would have been the actual cover. Can I swap it? I probably could. Let me see. Yeah, I most likely could swap the cover. But I don't know if I'll do that. Yeah, realistically, I could swap the cover. But this is the Cash and Sins. I should probably see if I should. Let me just make sure this is... Yeah, I really could, honestly. If I really didn't like it that much, I could just go like this. Doesn't really change too much. But it doesn't have the... Yeah, it does. But I don't know. Something about it just doesn't match up when I put it like this. So let me just make sure it's correctly aligned. It doesn't have the Blu-ray thing on it. That's why I think it's wrong with it, if I'm not mistaken. So it'd be more or less like this. And this would be the spine. I don't know. It just doesn't look right this way, in my opinion. But I could be just crazy. Next up, I never watched this one, but my friend told me it was pretty good. Cowboy Bebop, the complete series. This one's quite nice looking. I guess it's just something about this cover I don't like that makes it plandish. Because again, it just doesn't match the spine. But it's Cowboy Bebop. People told me it's good. Back when I had my afro hair, somebody said I kind of looked like the main character. And I did want to check it out. So that's kind of one of my reasons on wanting to check it out. But it has 4 discs. It's roughly 26 episodes. I thought this was a longer one, but it's a nice cover. I never did check this out. I will watch it soon. I do want to check it out soon. But, so Cowboy Bebop, nice cover. Nice little slip-on. I wish a lot of them came with slip-ons like this because they're quite nice. But, that's roughly it for the Blu-rays. I'm almost done. And last but not least, I bought 2 things. One of them I did an unboxing of, and another one I did too. I just didn't upload it yet, which I probably will upload before this video. Bought the R9 280X graphics card. I'm doing benchmark videos, so you will be flooded with a bunch of gameplay videos with no commentary. So I apologize for that. I'll upload them all in one day. So I'm uploading them now privately, and I'll release them all at the same time. And then throughout later on, I'll probably do a few more with newer games, maybe like Grand Theft Auto 5. But this graphics card beast took up like the inside of my whole desktop, and it was quite a shame. But it actually makes my CPU kind of overheat when feeling around a certain spot. So I do try to limit how long I play with it because there's not that much ventilation because this graphic card is so huge. I also bought a power supply, which you've seen. I already put them both in, so I wasn't going to do a video on that because I never really did it before, and that would take forever. I did watch videos, but more or less what I did was I just looked at what was inside my computer, unplugged certain stuff, made sure everything attached properly, and made sure I had everything plugged in that I unplugged, and that's how I did it. So that's why I bought a pre-built computer, so I kind of would know how to do it more or less, you know, without having to start from scratch, which did cost more money in the long run because I will buy a new CPU as well, but I could kind of build a new computer at that point. But I talked long enough. That is a super ultimate recent pickups thing, Turbo Graphics Edition 2015 or 2016, whatever. And I probably bought other stuff, most likely on Steam, digital downloads, and all that jazz. And I'm running out of breath at this point in time. And so hopefully you enjoyed it. That's what I've been doing, that's what I've been buying. And as you see with all these games, my backlog is just huge. And I kind of feel bad for buying all this stuff. But yeah, this is me, the Almighty D. There we go. Signing out, making sure I'm not forgetting anything else. Deuces. But yeah, that's it. So please check out the rest of my channel or subscribe. I doubt anybody who's watching this is new to my channel, because it would be kind of strange. But if you are, shout yourself out below. I'll appreciate it. And yeah, please, deuces.